Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and I need to put to some small inserts to this journal. It's not finished yet, I'm somehow taking time. So I was thinking I'm gonna share with you what I'm gonna do. Some easy small insert. This time I'm not gonna use envelope. This time I was thinking to use A4 size paper. This paper pad, it's in A4 size, which means it is in the size of printer paper you can buy. So I'm gonna choose one paper from this block because I like those papers and they can be amazing addition to your journals. Which one I'm gonna use? This one, it's nice. It has a soft color. So this one will be good. And I'm gonna score it somehow and then fold it somehow and create something like folder with pockets. Something I can add there. Some tags and some ephemeras. So I'm gonna score from this printed size because then I can fold it that way. So first scoring line will be 1/2 inches. So my paper, it's 8 1/4 by 11 3/4. It's the size of A4 size of printer paper. So 1/2 inch is first score line. And then I'm gonna go on 7 inches here. I'm gonna flip it this way and I'm gonna score 1/2 inch again. 1/2 inch. 4, 7, 1/2. Yeah, I think I can go this way. So 1/2 inch, then I'm gonna do 4 inches. This is 3 1/2, so plus 3 1/2, it's 7 1/2. And I'm gonna leave that rest. So 1/2 inch, 4 7 1/2 are those other score lines. I'm gonna take my scissors and I'm gonna cut. So here we've got 1/2 inch here and that 7 inches, and here 1/2, 4 7 1/2. So here I'm gonna cut this score line, the first cross of those score lines, and cut it to the angle. And I'm gonna do same here on the bottom, to that cross of those score lines, and with angle both sides. And here I'm gonna cut the angle. And I'm gonna cut all this rest. Where is that score line? I can't see that score line. I'm gonna fold it to make sure I can see. So here, where I do have that fold. Now, I'm gonna try to cut it, but I can't see it either. So I'm gonna just pretend I'm cutting in that score line. Like this. The other side, I'm gonna cut this one, this 1/2, 4 inches, 7 1/2. So here, that score line on 4 inches, I'm gonna cut the first cross. Here, where is that 7 1/2 inches? I'm gonna cut a little bit about 3/8 of inch. next to that score line, and I'm gonna make a notch here, that notch cutting. I'm gonna fold this inside and this inside. So we have that 1/2 inch, 4 inches, 7.5. Here I did cut about 3/8 inch from that score line, made that angle cut, fold it, and now I can cut that rest off. This middle part rest off. So I'm gonna show you. You can see that either way. So this is that 1/2 inch and 7 inches. 1/2 inch, 4 inches, 7.5. And we have piece like this. I'm gonna fold all these score lines now to make sure they are nicely folded. This one as well. Okay. Yeah, that can do the job. Okay, that can do the job. Good. So I've got everything fold it nicely. Now I'm gonna pull out my envelope punch board, and with that envelope punch board here, where you've got that middle part cut off, I'm gonna put this fold on 1 1/4 here and punch. I'm gonna flip it over. And now this fold, again on 1 1/4, here. And punch. And with my knife and ruler, I'm gonna cut that part between. This. So we have part which looks like this one. You've got those 1/2 inches folded. We've got this rest. It will be like flap of our pocket. And here we've got that rest. So before I will continue, I'm gonna make one more punch. On the opposite side, where you've got that 1/2 inch, 1/2 inch score line on this large piece, I'm gonna fold this inside like this, and I'm gonna cut the top here. I'm gonna cut this one first, and move that edge on 3.5. Like this. And with my guillotine, I'm gonna cut this rest off. I'm gonna cut it off with my guillotine. So I'm gonna move it here on the bottom, put that valet to the edge, to put those edges together, I mean that valet to the edge of that knife, and cut it like this. So I did cut it. Now I'm gonna take my small corner punch and just cut that corner. And I think that's the base done. So we have this one, and here I'm gonna just fold this extra piece inside like this. So it will make my pocket. Good. So I will have pocket here and pocket here, and it can be this way like a folder, or this way like a folder. So we're gonna somehow decorate it, and because I wanna use it in that cut journal, I think I'm gonna use some papers from this collection. Here, this is just for me because I like it when those flaps has that angle in those corners. So first I'm gonna distress it. I'm gonna use just black ink because that collection it's gray, pink and black mostly. So I'm gonna use just black ink and distress all these edges a little bit, not too much. Don't wanna make it dark, I just wanna little bit put the shade on those edges. So I do have all these edges a little bit distressed with that black black soot ink, and now I'm going to put it all together. So first I'm gonna add glue to these folds. It's really easy, this one. It's nothing complicated. I'm not gonna do any complicated closures here. So then just fold it over and glue it down. And that's why I like to use this office paper, because it's always look good. Then I'm gonna put glue here on these small folds. And I've got pocket here, and make it a little bit more matching my journal. I've got here from one of these background papers from this collection. They are really soft papers, pink and that Maui, I think it's called Maui color. So it's kind of mix of very soft colors. So I did cut piece 6 by 3 and 5/8, and I'm just gonna glue it here like this. So I'm gonna put glue on that piece and just slide it there. And just like this. Slide it there and make position for my paper. Now I'm gonna fold everything together. Use bone folder to fold it nicely. And here, because you know, here is that flap. And I don't want to use, I'm kind of lazy. I don't want to use any closure, so I'm going to make a pocket and put that tag, which will hold that flap. So for that pocket, this part it's 3.5 inches. So I'm going to cut paper, I think 3.5 inches by 6.5. So I'm gonna cut paper 4.5, I think 4.5 by 4.25. I'm gonna take my scoring tool, and now the 4.5, I'm counting for the how long will be my pocket, and 4 1/4, it's for this, how wide probably will be my pocket. So with this 4 1/4 side, it's here, 4.5 side is here. So I'm gonna score half inch. Yeah, I hope half inch and half inch and half inch, like this. I'm gonna cut these corners. And these as well. And I'm gonna fold all these score lines. I do have printed this background on 200 grammage, 200 GSM cardstock, white cardstock or white paper. So it's nice and strong. I'm gonna a little bit distress these edges, and I've got here those offcuts. So maybe I can use something here on the top to reinforce a little bit that top of this pocket. I'm gonna use that black ink just on the top of this strip and on the side. I'm gonna put glue here, like this. Like this, and maybe something on the bottom. I think it can be here, just like decoration. Like this. And now I'm gonna add glue to those folds, and place it on the top of this pocket or this mini folder, like this. Of course, you can use your sewing machine and make sewing effects. You know, I love to use sewing machine right now. I totally forgot to try and use it. So, and then I can, you know, I can add something inside in that pocket, and hopefully this will fit, and just lock it with another tack. So it will be like this, and here to put some decoration in that collection. It's sheet where are some words, so I guess I'm gonna use some words, and the relax just pop up out. So I'm gonna use that relax word. I'm gonna cut these corners in the angle. To make it look like specimen label. And here I've got a strip of coffee dyed paper. Or tea dye paper. So I'm gonna use that as my background and place it right here. and cut. So now I can place it right here, and I think I like it there. So I'm gonna put glue here on this side, because that will be somewhere here, and here on this side that will be somewhere here. I wanna leave open this entry. To that pocket, so I'm not gonna add there glue on my label like this. And some tack. What I've got here, I've got some book page tack. I cut few of them, and I've got some left over, and wonderful, nice. And tack, and I've got so many embellishments here, so maybe I can use these here. Cut them there. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna create some tack. Is this big enough? Ah, that's exactly actually. Okay, I'm gonna create tack. So I could hit this piece. Yeah, you can do that. If you like to have that you know, ripped paper effect, so I'm gonna rip that strip of paper. Use very lightweight that black suit again. Okay, I'm gonna add their glue. Okay. Not on my tape. And I'm gonna glue it down. Which way? Which way I would like it? I think I'm gonna follow the line on that book page. Like this. Here I'm gonna cut that off. And that second piece I'm gonna use as well. From the other side. So I think this side it's kind of fragile. So I'm gonna use it there. On this side. A little bit more of glue. Yeah, that's nice, reinforced now from both sides. That's good. And again, if you like to use sewing machine for tacks, it's always perfect. So what I'm gonna do next, I've got here this I made few small like tacks, and I'm saving them for projects like this when I need just small teeny meeny small paper. So I think I'm gonna use it here. I would like to have there some pink color. Do I have some strip of pink somewhere? Just let me have a look. I've got really so many. So many leftovers like this. So many. What I've got here. Yeah. Okay. Like this, and And I'm going to use scissors and a little bit ripped off the edge. And if I will place it here, yeah, I think I will like it there. Oh, well, look at that color. Which color I'm going to use? This way or this way? I think this way. Oh, okay. That was double-sided print, what I used for pages in the journal. That's why. And I'm gonna place it here. Like this. Cut it. And cut it here. And put a little bit more glue here, I guess. That is not in the end. So that's this one. And I've got, where is it? No, there is it. So here I've got that tea-dyed paper. And here I've got one of these offcuts from that folder. So it's kind of big. I'm going to cut it a little bit down. And I'm going to fold it nicely. Not press it together. I'm just need to cut those corners evenly. Like this. And I think I'm gonna make here tap from the bottom. So yeah, like decoration, you know, I like to use cans lately. We felt in love with that you know, possibility I can use cans. So I made for myself a few of these reinforcers using cans, soft drink can. We've got them prepared here, just few of them. So I'm gonna use one of these. Just gonna brush it a little bit, yeah, to make it look more vintage, like this. And I do have video how to prepare can for craft. So if you would like to have a look, I do have also video about tools I'm using. There is also this tool. This is 6 years old since I found this craft family. It's still same tool. It's like unbreakable. Here I'm gonna put this one. So it's in that video, it's also what is it and how to prepare it for distressing. I'm gonna add glue here and slide it here under my paper like this. And to cut this reinforcer, I used dies, metal dies, and I will put all informations down below what dies I did use. They are from planners dies. I don't remember exactly the name of that, but I will put all informations down below. I'm gonna just glue it here. What kind of offcuts I've got here? There's so many. Can use something else, why not? You've got really so many those small pieces. Oh, like here, these small pieces. Yeah, why do not use that? They are from my journal of cuts, so they are from same collection. Here is one more, so I'm gonna use that as well. And just easy way, nothing stressful. Gonna place it right there. Yeah, I will like it there. Okay, so from one side, glue it. I hope I'm in middle. It looks like I am in middle. I will see. And side, I'm not sure if I will match the shape of these. They are kind of all kind of, yeah, nearly similar. Do I have one more of these small pieces? Yeah, I do. So here I can use one more, just easy way. And I've got here this one. So why do not make it different way, right? No. I like it here. Actually, why not? Why do not place it this way? It's cute. So underneath, I'm gonna use one of those other papers. This way, yeah, I can do that. Okay, so here I'm gonna place this. And I need, oh, this one. Yeah, my magic, beautiful, magically wonderful strip from Office Papers. This is like magic. And I'm gonna put the glue there. So no hard closures or something very complicated. This is really easy craft. Just layering papers the way you like. way you think you will like it on your project. I think here, and maybe some wort. Maybe not. Maybe I will leave it just like this. I will see. Maybe later I will have a look if I do have some dye with cats, and then I will place it down there. So I'm gonna keep it this way. Easy way. Nothing too complicated. And then I can just slide it to my tag, and I do have and I've got here, yeah, you got these paper clips we created a few days ago, so it's dry. And I also did paper clips in the shape of butterflies. I'm gonna show you. Once I was in the fussy cutting all these shapes, so I tried butterflies. So I've got here my butterflies, and I do have paper clips like this, using all kind of scraps, and it's same technique. You can use any kind of shape. It doesn't have to be circle or butterfly. It can be any kind of shape, and it looks amazing with that liquid glass. It's strong and it's holding really well. So here are my butterflies using scraps. And I've got so many of butterflies, like decoration now. And all of them have that liquid glass, like top coat. All of them are made same technique like I made those paper clips. So I will put links down below for all these videos about tools I'm using, about how to prepare can. And also these paper clips, if you haven't seen that yet. Maybe you will like it. And I think that's all. Where is my journal? Here is my journal, so we have something to add there. I've got here this small booklet. Ah, here I've got pocket. So I can place it right here. Like this. So this is my sharing for today, small booklet, and I'm planning to do that journal, that tutorial for journal / lab book. So I hope you will join me soon. I'm nearly there. Have a wonderful day. Thank you so much for sharing your time with me today. Take care about yourself, and see you next time. Bye.